There's a spiritual connection to these lands. Tribes lived off the land, depended upon the land to provide us with the gifts that the Creator created for us. Without those gifts, we wouldn't be who we are. So we protect these lands. Bonjour, I am Mark Duffy. I am the Chief Conservation Officer for the Red Cliff Band of Lake Superior Chippewa, located on the northernmost tip of Wisconsin. We are still a small community up here. Everybody helps everybody. It's a great place to visit, great place to live. Come on up and visit us, and I'll tell you a little bit more.
We're spiritual people. Creator gifted that with us, and I'm really blessed to have that. He gave us responsibilities. And ours is to take care of the earth, the land, and the water.
The people of Red Cliff have been here for many years, stewarding the land, and that includes all of the landscape and the water bodies here. The lake itself surrounds Red Cliff. And there are many streams that flow into Lake Superior, lots of wetlands, inland wetlands, as well as coastal wetlands on Lake Superior.
Wetlands are very important for the tribe because we live off our lands. We live off of nature.
Wetlands are great for providing clean water for people. Wetlands are also great for flood management.
We have medicines that grow in wetlands. We have food that grows in wetlands. So with wetlands, we protect them. And it's not aspects of keeping people out. It's keeping damage out of, or pollution from coming into.
One of the challenges in Red Cliff is that a lot of the uplands are outside of the reservation. Anything that happens upstream, such as development or logging, isn't under the control of Red Cliff. Having wetlands on the landscape can help to mitigate some of those impacts from reaching Red Cliff. And now the Red Cliff Band has decided to invest even more in wetlands by creating a wetland program. This program will monitor and map wetlands in order to better protect as well as improve the health of wetlands here in Red Cliff.
We have a person that can get out there and see and make recommendations on how to protect our wetland areas. It's very important for us to have that because in the world of today, that expert holds a weight along with our traditional knowledge holds weight. And together, it creates a better buffer zone for us to make sure that we maintain, protect, and enhance the biodiversity that a wetland brings.
I think things are changing. One thing that has really happened is the revitalization. The revitalization of our language with the gathering, the hunting, the fishing. The same with the water. You'll hear that there's water blessings. We bless our water. You know, if we're disrespectful to the water can change just like that on us. We can never take things for granted because we're not guaranteed that it's going to be there. So we do things in that way to make the world a better place.
We are trying to create this thing here in Red Cliff that creates the environment that we live in today is secure, so that person that is 100 years from now can still come back here and pick medicines, still be able to harvest wild rice, still be able to get fish that are clean and good to eat. You know, that's the way we live because we have to keep our environment safe and sound for the 7 generations to come.